May is the end of whatever's happened before.
Anne isn't sure that she can bring about an improvement in the sales team's performance on her own.
Lovely Coventry skyline over there.
So she's invited a dynamic young business consultant to pitch for the job of helping her. But John is less than enthusiastic.
Are you excited? This is going to be the start of something big today, John. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm.
You don't normally like consultants, do you, John?
No.
You normally think that you know better than they do, don't you?
No.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's right, because if they're so fucking good, how come they ain't doing it then?
We really need to get an idea on why people are and why people aren't buying from you.
I can't bear to think that people are laughing at us because they've gone on the website, we've put shitloads of money into getting these leads, and they're going cold. Mm. We've tried the carrot, we've tried the stick, we've tried chocolate bars. We've tried everything. You know, we've got to do it a different way, and I'm excited about this.
Okay, then. And how much is it?
Well, the way that it works is it's very, very simple. I charge myself at a direct 500, which is a very competitive rate.
But if we said we want
we
what
said,
would be the sixth, how
fuck
much would
you,
that
we
be?
Can do it ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And everyone.
So are you going to increase the call rate, then?
Well, the thing is, it's a number of things we'll do, and one of the things will be increasing the call rate. The
well,
other
there
thing...
you are. So if we increase our call rate, we've done what you've done without having to pay you. What was, and now what is, and is to tomorrow a new day? Yes, it is.
Okay, that doesn't make any sense to me.
You're trying to put the tyre on the rim, and we ain't even got the spokes in yet.
If we're going to stop at the roadside and we're going to be putting a wheel back on, we might as well get onto a completely different road and go for it.
Yeah, but Anne, what I'm saying is that before you can go down that road, you've got to make sure the vehicle's got oil and water in, right? That we can do that. We don't need someone to come and do it for us.
But you need them to bring the mat to the new road.
What I'm saying is, we can put our own wheel back on.
Okay.
We can do it ourselves.
All right, well, we'll do it ourselves.
Because basically, he's going to come here, charge you £5,500 to tell you that the bucket's got holes in it and that's why
right,
it's got a leak.
Fine.
Fucking robbing
John.
Some cunt and coming back for more.
John, can we sort it out?
Despite John's insistence that they can improve matters on their own, Anne's convinced of the need for fresh impetus and has decided to advertise for a super salesperson.
Talk of concentrated evil. How are you then? All right. You're looking very smart today.
Thank you. I've just had an idea.
Oh.
I think we need to look for something a little bit different. We're looking for something special. We're looking for that certain something.
Mm.
And I'm a great believer in you can't tell how somebody's going to turn out. You can sit and talk to them until the cows come home, but, you know, I want to look at their personality and see what's behind the CV. So, anyway, that's my theory. I want some people with a bit of go about them.
Anne's advertisement in the Coventry Evening Telegraph produces just one applicant, 34-year-old Michael Handel.
I think he'd do quite well, personally. I think he'd fit in here quite well. I mean, that advert costs £120 and he's the only fucker who's sat in that chair. So he's got to fucking do it, right? And you will do it, won't you? Because, you know, he seems... I'm telling you, all the waifs and strays from all walks of life end up in double glazing. You'd be all right, fucking hell. I mean, see some of the people who've come here. You know, they've fucking managed.
This is our sales office. What we've got in here is our two lovely sales guys that are working down the bottom.
Right. Very good. Might have ironed his shirt before he come, Mike. It's Neil.
Yeah. He'd probably be just like the rest of them, he won't be here long.
For a week.
I'll give him about a week.
I think how well I do depends on, maybe other people don't, maybe this is not the usual way to go, but how well I get on anywhere is how well other people get on with me. You know, if people like me and are prepared to put up with the occasional weak joke, you know, then that's fine. You know, we'll all get. If people want to put me in a box and say, well, he doesn't belong with our group, you know, then that's where it could be a little tricky. But I think from all the people I've seen today, I don't anticipate any problem.
Really looking forward to it. It's going to be really good.
On a roll after recruiting her new salesman, Anne's now persuaded John to let her hire a specialist consultant to motivate the expanding sales team.
This morning, we've got a meeting with, I don't know what to call him. He's been sold to me as a motivational type guy. We had somebody in to do some product training for us the other day, and although he admitted that our sales guys were a little bit brighter than they had been the previous time, he still thought that a couple of them probably weren't breathing at one point in the meeting. They were just very flat. It's just trying to keep them up. And we're sort of running out of ideas. So we've got to look at other ways now of getting around this, you know, keeping them motivated. So this guy said, look, I can put you in touch with Basil and he'll come along and have a talk to you.
It's a bit like, you ever seen Braveheart at the beginning? And he goes, you can fight for your family, you can fight your friends, but they can't take away your freedom. The principle is the same, isn't it? Well, he motivated them, didn't he? It's time-honoured, tested. Let's see how much he is like Mel Gibson.
The man John's paying to try and inject some energy into the UFIT sales team is Zimbabwean motivational guru Basil Meany.
You seem to think you have a little of a problem.
I think I don't have a problem myself. It just seems that they're a bit flat sometimes.
We never have a failure with our programs. We don't have disappointed customers.
I'm just going to do a quick induction with Michael so he knows where he can smoke and not. Over the next couple of days, you've got an awful lot of information to take in and you've got a lot going through your head, so, you know, just take it easy.
Right,
now this morning we have got...
Mr. Motivator.
Mr. Motivator is coming in to talk to everybody, so if you just want to make yourself comfortable in here and we'll get the rest of the crew and we'll be back in a second. Okay.
Imagination is one of the most important things in our life. But when you have a no limitations belief on yourself, anything's possible. Who knows what the slight edge means? You guys, what do you think the slight edge means? The slight edge is very, very tiny, but the results are the best. And that's what all of us should be striving for, is that slight edge. We should be looking for the slight edge. Because you know what? When you take the most successful people in this world and people who are unsuccessful, there's very little differences in them, you know? Just the very successful people have the slight edge. Starting to make a little bit of sense to you? And one of the ways that you can think about getting that slight edge is through positive expectancy. Do any of you understand what positive expectancy is? Michael, what is positive? You're nodding your head there. What is positive expectancy?
Well, I'm familiar with most of this stuff.
Right.
Positive expectancy. You're after attaining a result and you expect to get it.
Right. They get that down the other end of the line as well. And they say, wow, this is somebody who's speaking with authority. This is somebody I want to deal with. you guys starting to get an idea of how powerful positive expectancy, how powerful self-belief actually is, how it can change the world. So you guys like a small little break here and relax a little bit?
Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Have some coffee or tea or whatever you fancy, or the smokers have a smoke break.
Why don't you come work here? Hey?
You'd pay me enough.
You'd write your own cheque, wouldn't you? You would, yeah.
Not a rock magic.
No.
Write two checks.
And on top of that, I love what I do.
You'd love work, yeah, but think of the future.
I am the future.
He did his whole positive thinking thing, which I'm more than familiar with all that stuff anyway, so I was, just struggled not to be bored to tears, really.
That girl, I think, is going to be very good. She pays a lot of attention.
Yeah.
That Luke pays a lot of attention.
Yeah.
The youngster that you've just taken on already knows it all.
Yeah. Have you been looking at him?
Yeah, he's got a very serious attitude problem. He hasn't even opened his little folder.
Yeah. But I had to turn it away because it was getting me down, so...
Yeah.
It could prove to be very enlightening for a lot of people who maybe never come across it. But for me, I'm already a world champion in my chosen field. So I kind of like, I take that and I take from wherever else as well. So.
John, what are we going to do?
Give him a try. Remember that there's no limitations belief
That's
on
true.
Everybody. Give him a go. He might be able to change him and he might become a really good person. No, I don't see why he can't.
But never mind, we'll see.
Well, he's on a trial. Did you put in his letters 10-day temporary trial basis?
6 months.
6 months? It is not 6 months. I told you
it's
when it was in an interview, it 10 months, 10 weeks, 10 days.
It? All right, then.
So well, you're going to keep him here for 6 months?
No, we're not going to keep him here for 6 months. I pointed out in the contract, it says that at any time in the first six months, we don't have to give a reason.
Yeah.
But you're already thinking that you're getting rid of him.
Well, you know.
You might have sold the conservatory by the end of the day.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, he's your star. You employed him.
You fucking employed him.
I kept quiet in this one. All I did was invited him in for an interview. I knew I'd get blamed. I knew it.
Got to do my stretching exercises now.
Do you know what you're doing?
Yeah.
The dog's going to help you now.
Yeah.
Oh. Man and dog stretching. John is very, very driven, so full of ideas, and it doesn't matter who tells him that it's not going to work, it doesn't matter, he just doesn't see obstacles, he just goes for it. There's no shortage of ideas with him, he just comes up with things that, you know, seem a bit far-fetched and a bit bizarre at the time, but they work, because he really is a driven person. He'll go through any obstacle. He'll go through any person who tries to stand in his way.
John has had this idea that we can perhaps sell windows to builders in France, which is a lovely idea. That's great, but we don't really speak a word of French between us, so it's going to be quite challenging. Hopefully, because this is a completely new area, it's still something he knows about. Obviously, it's windows and conservatories in any language. So hopefully that will give him a bit of spark, and he loves France anyway.
Je voudrais des fraises, s'il vous plaît.
Je voudrais des fraises, s'il vous plaît.
Je voudrais des fraises, s'il vous plaît.
I said that.
Le prochain train pour Dijon, part à quelle heure, s'il vous plaît?
Oh, shit. Let's try the other side, it might be easier.
What are we going to say to these people in France?
We are looking to supply contracts in France. Yeah?
Mm. We are looking... we are looking...
to... supply.
That's how it's going to go. We have been in business for 9 years. Otherwise, they might think we're some twats who made this up on the plane on the way over. Should we say we specialise? Because we do in conservatories.
Mm-hmm.
We specialise in
the manufacturing of conservatoires.
And it is a DIY bricolage.
Without the need
for specialist assistance. And we are able to supply air conditioning units for this conservatory in your hot, hot land where the sun is very strong. But nothing ventured, nothing gained. So we're driving down there with a window, and I think there's a massive potential there for the conservatories.
With their sales pitch drawn up, they're putting their trust in an internet website to translate it into French. Before they embark on their conquest of France, John and Anne want to follow up on some of the issues raised by Basil.
From yesterday's point of view, did you find it beneficial?
As I said, I don't think it was appreciated, but I have been through all that before. Mm. I'm not with him personally, because I've got to... Throughout my life, I've been pretty much defined by the board game Othello. I'm a sort of a professional Othello player, if you like, and that's all I do until recently. Mm. It's all my whole focus has been tournaments, you know, performing in tournaments against like-minded guys, and so this whole positive thinking stuff is. It's useful, it's important, but it's not the be-all and end-all, and there's a lot of other stuff.
Yep.
I've got to ask for time off at some point so I can go and play in these World Championships. Is that going to be arrangeable?
So obviously you started the job prior to knowing that you were... At the interview, you didn't tell us that you were intending to have...
You didn't ask.
You didn't tell us, did you? Did you know?
Yeah, oh yeah.
So why didn't you tell us?
I have an allergy to bragging, and there's a talk about Othello and the achievements that I've
done. Well, we're not bothered what you do, it's the actual time away from the business that we're concerned about. Well, we'll have a discussion about it and let you know.
Cheers.
That's
then.
Lovely, thank you.
When do you think you can get back to me on the...
Oh, tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning, yeah?
Yeah, no worries.
Okay.
Feel free to check out Othello websites, whatever you want. Verify the dates for yourself.
Okay.
Okay.
All right then, thank you.
Thanks, then. What do you mean I didn't fucking ask him? What, are you going to do it to a fellow, whatever the fuck it is, some Shakespeare fucking tournament, you know, a week after starting the job? He could have told us, couldn't he?
Disappointed by Michael's priorities, Anne's beginning to wonder if he's really the caliber of salesman she's been looking for.
I don't know what the answer is to getting people to come here. Or to, you know, it has got a bad reputation. I mean, you think of a double-glazing salesman.
I wouldn't have one in my house.
No.
I mean, if we had to buy windows, I wouldn't fucking have them. I'd have sacking. No, I shouldn't say that. It's not fair, is it? But most of them are cunts, yeah.
I've got my pillow and the porridge, Anne. We've just got to get the sat-nav.
Look what he's just put in the folder with the paperwork. Two slices of bread.
Yeah, because I'm fucking hungry, and I'll be hungry later. I've got to drive blooming 700, 800, 900 miles to fuck knows where.
And I would walk 500 miles.
John and Anne are beginning their assault on the French double glazing market in Montpellier, 815 miles away in the south of France.
Shit. Fucking assholes. I'm on the wrong side of the fucking road, aren't I? Ha 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 ha, you've got to go to work in all the shitty traffic. And for all we know, we might be having to turn around and get in the fucking...
Why don't we just slow down?
For fuck's sake, this ain't right. We should have gone that way. This fucking thing's sending us into Paris, isn't it? Shit, shit, fucking, why are the fucking cunts going home?
Oh, I'm getting a bit scared now. We're getting a bit close.
Aiming high, they've set up meetings with the leading window suppliers in southern France.
Flash.
Vous aviez quelques questions pour me poser? Vous voulez me poser quelques questions sur?
Oui, oui. Oui. Mais pour la réunion, nous aujourd'hui, merci beaucoup.
Oui.
So far, so good.
Voulez-vous vous asseoir?
Oui.
Assez. Merci.
Est-ce que nous pouvons vous donner une explication de nos produits?
Oui, bien sûr.
We will explain our products. Yes. Conservatoires.
L'addition de la maison conservatoire.
Est-ce qu'il y a beaucoup de conservatoires en France?
Conservatoire.
What's the other word we came up with? What do you like?
As a foil, the mahogany.
Wood grain.
Wood. A clip in all the way round. The ring beam sit on top of frame, aluminium roof, PVC, turnbuckle, cleat, bang, 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 to fasten roof frame. Instruction for bricolage, DIY man, homeowner.
I don't know, I can't.
In English?
Yeah, in English, yeah.
While the bosses try to drum up business abroad, sales back in Coventry continue to plummet. John and Anne are expecting results from Basil having paid him nearly £3,000 to motivate the sales force. But so far, he's failed to inspire.
He looks at me as a threat because, well, first of all, I'm very sceptical about all this stuff. And I'm sceptical about him.
Anne and John, they've brought into whatever he's sold them. I'm not saying that he's full of shit or anything like that. I'm saying what he does bring over to me, it makes a lot of sense. But he just seems to think that if you believe you can do something, you can do it, which is bullshit. If I jump out that window now, I ain't gonna fucking fly.
So it's what it takes to become a winner. That's the subject we're on today. And one of the things that we've got to look at is, first of all, are you using your best knowledge and your skills? In other words, are you applying everything that you know to the best of your ability in order to achieve the figures for today? Or are you, in quite blunt, horrible terms, stealing from this company? When somebody is continually making excuses and trying to get out of what didn't work, no, it's not my fault, you know, I've got a problem at home. My mind was busy concentrating on that. It's not the way it works, guys. You accept responsibility for yourself. That's how a winner attacks his job. Their behavior, the way they react towards things, is different. They see opportunities and they see excitement in what's going to happen. They don't see problems.
Voilà. En fenêtre.
Okay.
And instead of going in with the idea, well, I might make this work and I might not, you're going in with the idea, this will work.
that Mr. Bricolage or Arrive or Consignon or Angleterre or Kit 6 day under 12 day erection complete.
Liberace, the great pianist, he achieved the results that he achieved because when he was still brand new, he hired the best possible players, hired a hall, set up his piano and pretended that he was playing to a hall packed with people in there before it actually happened. Okay, so he faked it till he made it.
70 saucissons, climate control, air conditioning, electronic can be incorporated.
Je suis désolé, ne parle seulement français.
No, no. That is the power of the mind. You see, your mind controls whatever's going on. When Arnold Schwarzenegger went into movies, he said, I'm going to be one of the best movie actors that they've got. One certainly proved that, didn't he?
Do you think we're fluent?
No.
I think he understood.
I think he grabbed the prize and realised there's much profit in it.
Yeah, money talks.
It does, yeah.
And then you can see it by their results. Okay. Winners always end up with huge results. Losers don't have those big results.
Okay. And when we did tell him that the factory was 4,000 square metres, yeah, I'm not sure if that's true. I think it's more like, I don't know how big 4,000 square metres is. I mean, it sounds fucking huge to me.
They were quite impressed, though.
They probably is,
by the
actually.
Size of it. But then men will always have you believe that that's
no,
an
no,
inch.
No, 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 that's... It's, I think it's like 4,000 square metres, did I say?
Yeah.
That's 4 kilometres square. Nearly 1.5 miles. I just didn't realise. Oh, he was impressed. It really did impress him.
Well, they were impressed. They all went. That's like that momentary gasp. I'm starting to understand.
Certain clips of it.
Bye. What's the thing? Those fucking crackers.
It was an expedition, weren't it?
Bloody was.
You know, it was nice to know and hear and listen, and it's put a bit of spin on our plans. I mean, it's focused us up to the opportunity. I mean, there's no conservatories there.
But what if they phone us up and say they want to order something?
I want them to go online and do it, I don't know. But to be honest with you, there's other fish to fry here first. I'd spend a whole lot of time on it. It's not as if, you know, we're like the Roman Empire. We just started in France and seeing England over the sea. Oh, well, you know, we've got nowhere else to go. Well, let's go and invade England. We're not quite like that, are we? I mean, we're still sort of like in the early years of the Roman Empire. We're still in Rome, you know what I mean? We haven't even got into the rest of Italy yet.
Is that where we're going next, then?
Well, we've got, you know, we've got this... We've got to keep the home fires burning, haven't we?
I suppose we'll go and find out what's happening down there.
Yeah.
So off today, Luke and Rebecca, and Dan hasn't come in. I don't know, it's just it's a bit depressing, really. Come back from France on a high, ready to sell to the whole world, and then you come back here and you just think, oh, God.
Oh, I don't fucking know. You get past fucking caring, to be honest with you.
Cocksuckers.
You can't fucking win for fucking winning, can you?
With the company accounts making grim reading, Anne's patience is running thin.
I'm just wondering if I can sue our employees for stress.
Sensing the time for radical action, she's called in Basil for an emergency session to finally get to the root of the problem.
We have a small challenge. Could we perhaps today use you in a very slightly different way?
Okay.
Instead of doing the last session today,
right.
Could you perhaps listen in with them, spend a bit more time with them,
mm-hmm.
and see if there's anything today that you can suggest that they could be saying that's a little bit different, or leading on from what you did last week,
okay.
In sort of listening into them. How do you feel about that?
Yeah.
Just bloody, let's take action.
Stoke that bonfire up and let's get four gas rings going flat out.
What he's going to be doing is sitting in here and listening to the calls and see if he can help with anything that's being said or what have you. He's just going to listen in. Just ignore him. He's going to be sort of sitting in the corner there. But obviously, you've got to make the phone calls while Basil is in here, because we're paying for his expertise to see if he can help us in any way.
It's feeling the pressure.
Right, feedback on your stuff.
That don't work. That's it. It's as simple as that. I sat for 40 minutes and heard one guy make a couple of phone calls.
Who was that?
That was Michael. Your guys haven't a clue. I can tell you that right now.
What about Rebecca? Did she make any?
Not one phone call, spent more time shuffling a piece of paper in her hand. Continually got up and walked out of the office, all the time out of there. Doesn't answer the phone when it rings, and in fact, on one occasion I could see they were fed up, so they answered the phone and put it straight down again so that they cut the call off. The other fella never made a single phone call until eventually, I'm telling you. Then, when he did get on the phone, four phone calls that he made out, and every one of them left a voicemail and expected the client to phone him back. The only guy who put any effort in at all was mine. You've got to gain some excitement. You've got to get some excitement in there. They're dead. They just haven't fallen over. That's the problem. Yeah. You can't have a company survive with that kind of attitude in there. I'll tell you something now. I'd fire the whole bloody lot.
They, you know, it's just basically they've come along and sort of made us face reality, really, haven't they? No, you can't get blood out of a stone, can you? I don't know. Perhaps I could give them a last chance. You know, just say, you know, that we've got to do this, otherwise you fucking out. But they've had so many chances. Oh, I don't know. I'll go and have a little word with our wand and dinghy. We've got you in all here today to give you a bit of a frank talking to. You know, you need a bit of a wake-up call, so take this as a wake-up call. You know, smell the fucking coffee, yeah? The customer is king. You know, if someone left a message on your answer machine home and said, oh, by the way, if you are interested, give us a ring. Because he's going to think, fuck you, who the fuck do you think you are? Madonna?
And we've been
you're a little bit excluded from that, to be honest with you, Michael, because just to put him on a pedestal for a moment.
Yeah.
The only person he said was on the phone and just making the calls was Michael.
I just want to defend these guys as well, because...
Well, you don't have to, so don't.
I know it's...
You don't have to.
Well, I'm defending myself as well.
Well, I don't want to wear it. You're here. You ain't meant to be in here, really, to have a bollocking, right, but you are. Virtue of the fact, I'm the MD of the company, I'm telling you what I want you to do. If you don't want to do it, there's the door. I ain't bothered. You know, what the target is that you've each got to do 40,000 sales between now and December the 23rd. I'm not saying I'll just do it off the top. I've got something to help you do it. Right, now, we've come up with all, in all good traditions, we've got a Merry Christmas offer.
If people have decided in their own minds that they don't have any money until after Christmas, there's not a lot we can do about it.
We're not interested. We're asking, I don't want your feedback. I want you to phone up people and tell them that. That's what I want you to do. I'm not asking for a discourse about the realities of what people's buying behaviour is at Christmas. All I'm interested in is that you're going to go away and you're going to do that. OK, well, let's do it. Let's get that Christmas message across then, get them church bells ringing across the land. The Conservatory offered to beat all others. Yeah? Come on, smile. Where's your smile? You know, raise the corners of your mouth.
Well, I'm on.
Thank you.
What that Basil was saying was a load of bullshit. He was just chatting shit. Because I knew what he was going to say. About putting the phone down on people. I knocked the thing in, fucking it wrong, and then I put it down. It's not putting the phone down on people at all. And don't leave messages, what do I do then? Not speak to him. He's just fucking, I don't know.
It's just like you've just run into a, pure stubbornness, really. It's like a dad who's like telling his kid what is, you know, you will sell now because I told you to.
Fucking wanted to say something in their defence. Fucking hell, he's been here 3 fucking minutes. I don't know fucking jack shit. I think it would have been better getting rid of myself. Fucking hell. Fucking Albert Einstein's about to fucking speak.
And I don't see how, let's say, you're going to do it now or you're out on your ass is going to change anything, apart from, you know, fuck with morale, really. It was a lot easier for me to sell this morning, I'll tell you that.
Have you read this, John? Improving team performance.
I haven't, no.
Why?
Because I'm reading Cycling Weekly.
I think they've underestimated me, actually. I think I'm going to have to put my foot down a bit with a firm hand. I mean, I get the impression that they think I'm a bit soft and fuzzy. I think of myself as UFIT's stealth bomber.
Mm.
I'm the pilot of the stealth bomber. And I'm going to drop my payload if they carry on the way they are, I think.
Now is the time for action. Now is the winter of our discontent. I'm fucked off with wankers walking through that fucking door and pissing me about. God's sake, I tell you,
fucking idiot!
Gone to swing round, looked in my mirror, there's nothing there. Next thing of it, John's car.
See it, hit it. Well, hit it there and it's just gone in right at an angle. And
can't we report him to the police, driving without due care and attention? But the best of it is, we pay the insurance for that twat to be driving like that.
God's sake, I tell you, I fucking hate this. That's fucking done my head in.
You know, this is the bloke who a few weeks ago, we had a
but
phone call.
He's just resigned now, he's done us a favour.
Good! Fucking let him go. We don't need wankers like that. We got enough of the ones.
I can't fucking believe this. That's my fucking car, that is. I mean, I fucking spent...
We fucking work hard for this, and that
I mean, he's
bastard.
Gone and fucking done that. God knows how much that's going to cost. That is going to cost fucking shitloads. I can't believe that.
That is what you get with employing people. I suppose the twat will try and do us for some sort of thing now.
Well, he's the one who walked out. He said he's not being spoken to like that.
Good job he went when he did then.
Talking.
I'm shocked that seagull thing, bird, whatever it is. I'd just fly off and shit on someone else's head. She's back, isn't she? Annie's back. Didn't last long.
Me being the first of the people in this instance. Yeah,
I've just been thinking about that, actually.
Have you?
Yeah.
What am I to do then, today?
I've been coming down the same road for 9 years, coming into work. And the first thing you always do every morning, it's quite depressing really, is check who's come in, who hasn't come in, don't you? And then you can go out and you can sell all the windows and conservatories you like in the world. But then if the people don't come in to make it, you're scuppered. Where you're relying on people, you've got problems. If we could make the same amount of money with a quarter of the overheads, does that sound like a negative pill to you?
No.
It might be negative to the three quarters of the people who aren't working here anymore.
It calls...
But at the end of the day, does it bloody matter?
With the business still losing money, it seems that Anne's dream of a smaller workforce may soon have to become a reality.
The purpose of today's meeting is to discuss the recent downturn in the number of items being manufactured.
Because we've got some tough decisions, aren't we?
Right. For the number of items being manufactured this week, are we overstaffed?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because we said that this week is going to be down anyway. So far, so good. Do we need to make people redundant?
Yes.
Yeah.
We've got a very strange opportunity here, because let's be absolutely honest about this. The fact that we're sitting here in this position is because we haven't been converting enough sales.
Mm.
How about then, let's chuck the hand grenade in here. Could we lose three factory plus one driver? Plus one sales. I know it's the worst time almost to get rid of your salespeople, but it might make the others sit up and think, shit.
I at the moment, I'm thinking one glorious fuck up and that, you find out just how expendable you are. That's what I think at the moment. Just one messed up sale or whatever, or anything really, a wrong word to the wrong person. That's what I think of them. You know, I don't feel very secure about this job at all.
When they change something, if you don't like it, you know, just leave. So, we know the choices, just we've got to make one.
Though John's overruled Anne's plan to lose up to five members of staff, she's insisting they cut costs by making at least one person redundant.
Just got to tell everybody that, well, the reasons why, we've got to be honest with them. But as I say, they all know it's been so quiet.
It's left to John to explain to the men in the factory why one of their workmates has gone.
There's no easy way for a company our size to really come to terms with getting rid of someone we work with day in, day out. We don't take decisions like this lightly, and we couldn't afford to carry him with the volume we're doing. Now, we run a business here. You know, 2 plus 2's got to equal 4. That's what it is. No way for, you know, it might sound a bit harsh, but that's the way it is. So, any questions or anything? Anyone want to say anything? Ask me anything while I'm here.
Look at the amount of stuff I've got up here. Absolutely stacks of stuff. And now I can't get anybody to help me.
Well, you have got someone to help you.
They can't do it.
OK. Well, you need to speak to Andy Savory then, don't you, and Anne? All right, well, I won't keep you any longer then.
All right.
Sensing resentment on the factory floor, John's beginning to doubt the wisdom of Anne's decision.
Now, what do I have to go down there and fucking tell them?
What else were we meant to do? You've been telling us for weeks we're going to have to get rid of people.
Well, I did say you could have waited a fucking till the end of this week to see if it picked up.
If you like, John, I'll phone him up and tell him we made a big mistake. Just come back. We had a bad dream.
No.
His letter hasn't gone in the post. Is that what you want me to do?
No.
So you do think we made the right decision?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, the shit we've had today, I almost wish that we'd stuck with our original plan of saying, right, 3 or 4. Because we wouldn't have felt any worse.
No.
I just hope to flaming God that it can all be pulled right now and that we don't have to go through this again. Because next time, we're going to stick with the decision. And if we say 3, it's going to be 3. But I'll tell you what, a business that carries on carrying people is a business that's going nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to be like that?
No.
You know, the next time we do have to go to the bank to get our own bloody money to put into the place, to keep somebody because you don't want to let them go, let them come to the bank with us and see how difficult that decision is.
Mm.
Would they go to their bank and get their money out to keep somebody in a job? No.
No.
It's bloody us every time. Well, I'll tell you what. If you want people to stop making decisions and, you know, to stop the company moving on, then that's great. You carry on shouting at us for making a decision. It's been a bloody shit day.
As Christmas week begins, Anne's staffing nightmare shows no sign of ending.
On Monday, I came into work as usual, just expecting the last week to be quiet and totally uneventful. Dan, he turned round and handed me a piece of paper before I'd even opened my mouth and said, "Don't know whether this makes any difference." And I opened the piece of paper and it was his resignation. I sort of sat there stunned, really. And Rebecca, she'd got this piece of paper all folded up in her hand, sort of like this, rolled into a tube. I went to the sales office door, flung the door open, quite tongue-in-cheek, and said, "Right, before I go to the expense of reallocating these leads, are you two staying or are you going?" And Michael said, "Well, I'm staying." "Look, great, that's one." And Luke turned around and said, "Well, actually, I've got another job as well." They were like a house of cards, weren't they, John? Once one went, they all started. What did you liken them to this morning? Lemmings. I mean, stunned, yes. I mean, you're bound to be. You've just lost 3/4 of your sales team. But you've got to look at every opportunity, and I'm just thinking now, what a great opportunity we've got.
With sole access to the hottest leads, Michael's sales have improved significantly.
I was doing something right. Maybe I wasn't selling as spectacularly as Luke or Dan, but I'm here. They're not.
I think they just, you know, it's like they try and do things professional, but it's just not, it doesn't work. So there's no point trying, I don't think. So it'd be good for me in January to actually work for a professional company. But he just walks around doing fuck all day. He's just a fucking arsehole. He's an arsehole.
Yeah, no, he didn't help us at all, did he?
What, they didn't give a shit about anyone in there.
We have got the one person who is left. Let's face it, he's the one person who, since he's been here, we have never had to talk to about his timekeeping. Not once. Every time we look through that door at Michael, he's on the phone, isn't he, John?
Yeah.
He's on the phone. So. And he always is, every time we go in there.
So he's doing his job?
Yeah.
And he's getting results, so there's a fucking surprise.
And those results are earning Michael vastly increased commission.
That extra money, we're looking at maybe... It's reinvesting it into their company, if you like, because they're the ones who paid it. So trousers, shirts, ties, haircut. If I keep earning that sort of money, then we'll just carry on with that because, you know, take it a step at a time. Stuff. And yeah, and then I'd be happy to, once I'm comfortable in my own skin, I'd be happy to be the face of UFIT to whoever walks through the door.
I am so looking forward to next year. I really am. Because I just think when we've had this little break at Christmas, it'd be nice to come back, new year, new challenges.
Mm.
We can just move on now.
Mm. To all the fucking tossers that have previously worked here, Merry Christmas. Please don't ever get in touch with me ever again. Thank you.
As a new year begins, Michael's returning to work, having invested in the makeover he's been planning since his earnings increased.
It's actually quite a conservative new look. It's shoes and trousers and a shirt. And the shirt has actually had a passing acquaintance with an iron this morning. I feel like an extra in Saturday Night Fever or something. Get a paycheck of, what is it, £1,300? That's far and away the biggest paycheck I've ever earned for a week's work, by a long way. And it's worth putting back, you know, what you can. Because, you know, I'd like to be here in a year's time.
Looks smart again, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Do you think we ought to perhaps have meal out with him or something?
Meal out with him? Yeah. Well, why don't you have a fucking sandwich now?
No, it'd be nice to go out, get to meet his wife and... I mean, it'd be nice because at this point... Because he got off to a really good start with sales, didn't he?
Perhaps we might better motivate him. I mean, we've brought him this far, haven't we?
Yeah. Well,
and he's gone through the UFIT sort of stage stall, hasn't he? Out of chaos comes change, and out of change comes progress.
Hasn't Michael changed, though, since he came to us?
Well, there's chaos into fucking change, then, isn't there?
I feel very proud of him.
We are the makers of men.
So it might be an idea that we can, you know, just sort of give him assurances that he's safe with us.
Yeah.
Because he might be worried, hasn't he?
Yeah.
And also to build him up by letting him know how well we think he's done.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be anything grand, does it?
No. Yeah.
Right, there's nothing to worry about today, so don't panic.
Right, you keep saying that, which worries me.
But Michael, I'm sitting here and I'm looking at you and you are just like a new man.
Where you are, because that's where you've chosen to be. So, I mean, we keep hearing it again and again, and it must be true.
UFIT's changing all the time. Why don't I do the same thing?
But anyway...
Yeah, all right, yeah, but let's just move on to the next point. We ain't got all fucking day.
Right, we haven't got all day, apparently. So what we're thinking of doing is having an evening whereby we can sort of take you and your wife out one evening just for a little bite to eat, to get to know you a little bit better. Nothing posh.
Not for that, no.
Would that be of interest
well,
to you?
Well, it probably will be posh, won't it?
Won't be anywhere grand. We're not going to the Ritz or anywhere like that.
All we need to do is sort my wife out with something to wear.
Oh.
If we can sort her out with something to wear in public, then absolutely.
We're not going
to
wear posh.
Fucking gown.
Well, this is it. It's you've got to hide the shackle marks. You know. Okay.
About Indian? Do you like Indian food?
Yeah.
Why don't we go to that pink place, whatever it was called? What's it called? The Pink Bengal or something?
Oh yeah, we could go there. There's a place just up the road. It's very good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
And, all right. Oh.
If it helps at all, I don't, you know, I'm not planning on going anywhere.
Well, it's good to have stability and, you know, we appreciate your input and, you know, I think you'd be an asset.
That went well.
Yeah, it's nice to know that the boss thinks you're a pleasant enough company to eat with. Of course, we're going to have to review that after the actual meal.
After last year's sales exodus, Anne's taking some time out to develop a more effective management plan for the newly replenished sales force. But unknown to her, John is about to roll out a plan of his own.
OK, so today is going to be a bit of a groundbreak. I am in the mood for change, the first wave of change. The plan is called the 40 grand plan. And I think we can all deduce what that means is that what we're looking from you, Fit, is for £40,000 worth of sales a week, and interestingly enough, the wave of change. So please stop reading ahead of me. So the way forward is today, the way forward is now, yeah? So what we've got to basically do, I've considered this, is that we need someone to coordinate. So to do this, a sales manager, Michael Handel brackets, is required to take control of the training and instruction of new recruits. Do you want to do it? Because you will be accountable, yeah, and responsible for the results of being a sales manager.
Yes.
Do you want to do it? That's the only answer I want to hear. Congratulations, mate.
Thank you.
Give me a boy, I'll give you a soldier, said Napoleon. I can give you the support. We want to make you do it. And we'll say at the end of 2 months, as he cut it, ain't he cut it? That's all we can do, because it is a results-orientated position. We will be piling pressure on you, but the way we'll be piling pressure on you is to say, look, there's the leads. Has contact been made? Has it been quoted? Has it been sold? If not, why not?
It's not often that you come across someone with the flexibility to say, just run with this guy and see what happens. And I'm ready to, you know, as long as he's ready to keep saying that, then I'll keep running. Do you know, so fine. There's something about my star sign. I don't know how much that has to do with it. I'm a Pisces, so it's all about water. And the idea is that whatever container you put me in, I'll fill it. So if you give me a bigger box, you know, I'll just fill it. And if he keeps making the box bigger, I'll just go for it. You know, to the best of my ability, whatever that is.
But there is still one person who has yet to hear about Michael's good news.
Why are you hiding? What have you done?
Well, I've just had a brainwave. I've had a brainwave, haven't I?
Yeah, well, I'm not. This is about sales, isn't it? Mm. You've done something with the sales, haven't you?
I have remodelled it, yeah. But it's good news.
Who's the sales manager?
Michael.
Just talk to me about stuff.
Look, I ain't really thought it. Look, just.
No, you haven't thought it out. It's fairly obvious.
Put the brakes on now.
Thought it out. But do you not see.
I have thought it out, but you're making me think that I haven't thought it out, even though I have. Because you're throwing
some. Because you can't answer.
You're throwing another thing, another spanner in the wheel.
You got any other ideas or things that you've implemented while I haven't been here that you want to tell me about?
Not really, not that I can think of. Really, I've got to report to you on a regular basis.
No, I don't want to know. But don't complain to me either when it all goes belly up.
OK, well, thanks for your insightful wisdom. Do you think you can get me a key for this door as well?
Yeah, but opinions are like arseholes. Everybody's got one, and that was my opinion.
OK.
Oh, man, it's called the way the change. Just let it wash over you. It'll be all right.
I mean, if somebody asked me out, you know, for a meal, and it was my boss and, you know, partner, I think, oh, I'd feel quite honoured. I'd feel quite special.
Oh, please.
Yes,
yeah.
Please. Yeah. You don't normally drink.
I don't normally drink. I don't know why I'm drinking it.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Michael.
Hello.
You must be Judy. I'm John.
John.
Nice to meet you.
Hello, Judy. Lovely to meet you. Yes, yes.
Michael's told us a lot about you.
Yeah.
I don't know what that means.
You've got a lot to live up to.
Michael's been married to Judy for 7 years. They met on a website for the board game Othello.
He could be a star performer. Mm-hmm. If he could just give us 10% of his grey matter and we can just inject our little bit in, he'd be flying. What strengths do you think are his biggest work, biggest strength then in terms of...
Well, size of my willy.
Oh, my God, you are.
Excuse me, we're just about to eat some dinner.
Yes.
So we didn't hear that.
No, okay. Just doing that himself. Michael's biggest strength could be interpreted as weakness as well. He's honest to the point of stupidity sometimes. And sometimes he's honest when maybe he'd be better just to keep his mouth shut.
You've been there 3 months. I mean, I know you've worked at a few different places. What's your overall impression of our organisation? Well, say what you feel or do what you normally do, be honest.
Actually, I've got so many ideas, I don't know where to start. But I'll get back to you because I'm hungry.
So the best thing to do is email them up to me. I'll put a red line through the ones I think that stink, and the ones that I think are any good we can talk about.
Okay.
That's such a happy couple.
While Anne's pleased with the improvement in Michael, she's made no secret of her reservations about his promotion. So she's relieved to have had a call from Luke, who's keen to return to the UFIT fold, even though John said he never wants to hear from him again.
You see, I know how to handle John beautifully, and I know that he likes to think that he's come up with all these ideas. You keep trying, you keep dropping the ideas, and then eventually they do go into him, but then they come out regurgitated as being his idea.
Here's the sail. See you, boy. You're doing all right,
yeah.
Good to have you.
Aww.
It's nice to be lying in bed and saying, well, out of the three, would you have? I said, oh, it'd be Luke, wouldn't it?
And we didn't hesitate, did we? When you phoned up, the pair of us were like, yeah.
You know what it's like here, don't you? Mm. We're going, we're coming, we're going, no, we're not, we're coming. So nothing much changed, mate.
Fine.
Yeah.
Aww.
Smashing. Nice to have you back, boy.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
So we'll see you Monday, 9 o'clock.
Right. Yeah. Make sure you fucking turn up, won't you?
I'll be here.
Yeah, I know you will.
Uniform and that.
Check out the hot chocolate. Yeah. See you, lad.
Aww.
And I had a day off and free.
Luke is starting again on Monday, and I think really he's got to run rings around Michael.
And then to top that, you.
It doesn't help you feeling for job security, does it? But, you know, give it time. If you see John breathing down my neck, going, what's going on, then you'll know it didn't work out. And if John's going, buy that man a drink, then, you know. It's very different from day to day, isn't it? If you have a good day, it's like you're everybody's hero, and then if you have a quiet day, it's you're not. It's quite the opposite. That's pressure. That's a bit of pressure there. I'd like a bit more of an even keel if at all possible. But anyway.
I want sales manager job. I'm probably the most experienced salesperson here. Well, no doubt I am. I'm a good role model for them because I'm here, sort of like setting an example week in, week out with my figures and stuff, as opposed to like Michael.
There's about 12 points I just wanted to touch on as far as this email to John goes. And I don't really want to elaborate on them too much until I get some feedback. It's like, and John goes, 11 of those is just blow it out of your ass, Michael. But this one we might do something about.
Number 8, you know already. The order process is awkward, clunky, and it breaks down if any link is missing. No, I don't have a better idea. Why say it then? I don't think I'd have taken the risk myself, personally, of emailing my boss saying, this bit's shit, but I don't have a better idea. I don't think I'd have done it myself, but he's obviously a very brave man.
I'm not going to sit around with my mouth shut. I'm too... I just can't do... I don't care how fearsome the beast at the top of the tree is. I just can't do that.
John won't be told anything. Bless him. I don't know how John is going to respond to it. It's because I think he got the email before I did. And, I don't know. I think he might take offence at some of those, actually.
Morning.
He doesn't look very happy.
I'm asking myself a lot of questions now. Like, who is, like, watching John's back? You know, who, you know, he can't be expected to do everything, to know everything. Yes, he's the man and everything, but you know, you can't do everything. You've got to have someone out there who's saying, look, John, you know, this is not happening. This is not right.
Required for 3 months troubleshooter here with degree and or experience in business management to analyse the company, make suggestions and advise on standard business practice on what has been proven to work. Who's taking advantage of you? Who would tell you so? No one, it seems. Not in their job description. I actually said, put manager, you fit sales department. That's a fucking joke. Couldn't manage a fucking piss up in a fucking brewery. Well, you live and learn, don't you? You know, we've got to have a fucking exit strategy.
No!
You better start shouting up your fucking axe. Heads are gonna fucking roll, baby. Said Anne Boleyn.
I got a reply on the email. Extremely brief. Some valid points he's got here, especially 6 and 10.
Tell you one thing I'm thinking of. Well, Napoleon's army, right? He had what he called his Imperial Guard. Mm. Well, that's what we need, an Imperial Guard. I just want to get that, you know, like that big old train moving out the station there. Yeah? Well, we can't, you know, it's like the train doesn't do 100 mile an hour from the moment it's turned on, does it? But it starts, you know, it's got to make that start. And that's what we've got to do. We've got to start them up. It's the UFIT way or the highway. Morning, guys.
Hey, morning.
You all set for some training? Then you're in the right place. But there's only ever going to be one of you. Never again will there be you. Because you are unique, you are worth billions.
I've just focused on doing what I'm told as much as I can. The results have been shit as far as I'm concerned.
You can dress and look like $1 million and you will perform like $1 million. Because we feel good about ourselves.
Several hours of shit before they can go and fucking sell something. I've got my own ideas. My ideas might be just as bad, but if you're taking on someone and you've got the cheek to call them a professional, you know, you should let them demonstrate their professional approach.
You can never let someone take away and destroy your self-image, because if you do, then you've lost control and you might as well be a bag of paper blowing around in the wind, because the wind will blow you wherever it wants. Instead, be the wind. Mate, sounds kind of crazy, doesn't it? Sounds like flying all the way to the moon and 5 foot before touchdown, turning around and coming back home. That is madness. Don't let them take control of what the way you feel and think, because you are the person, you are your universe, and you are the one who is the winner and is unique. Yeah? Well, that's good news, really good news. Don't deny yourself that opportunity. Don't say no to yourself, say yes.
You know, I mean, tomorrow, this place is ups and downs, isn't it? So, we're due for some ups now. We'll see how things go after that.
Just 3 weeks into his new job as sales manager, the mounting tension between Michael and his bosses has finally come to a head over his failure to use John and Anne's expensive database system, ab initio.
I was sat here the other day and I ventured into one of our databases. It's where you put in customer details, name, address, email address and stuff like that. Women's intuition, I don't know, but I just thought I'll have a little look and see how he's been getting on. He just hasn't been bloody doing it.
I'm just trying to manage the leads that come in, but with all the stupid distractions going on, I'm not actually getting to, you know.
I took it to Prada for Valentine's Day, yeah?
For every lead I deal with, there's three more that come in.
Why are you pulling faces behind me?
I'm not. I'm thinking, there's my Anne. You're doing a grand job.
Now, I've got to be honest, I didn't agree with John making him sales manager. And I think John has probably come to realise that it perhaps was one of our mistakes. What we're going to do today is...
He's been very naughty.
Is have a meeting with him. He may turn around and say, actually, I don't understand that particular database. I feel I need more training on it. I've been frightened to say that it's an area that, you know, in that case, that is absolutely fine. I'm not going to shit on his head and beat him up with the bits of paper I have got. But if he turns around and says, no, I think I've really mastered it, you know, or worse still, starts picking his nails and not answering me, then I will present what I've got.
Go in.
No, I think you'll see a different side of me today.
Get that Rocky video on.
When I've got something to say and it's in this sort of situation, I'm very, very calm.
Yeah.
He's the one who suggested...
I think there's a bit of an atmosphere and I think it'd be best to get it out in the open.
Don't... Will you leave it to me?
No,
you're not going to...
think... No, not with me, but I think, you
you're
know,
not
there's
just
an atmosphere.
Butt in, are you,
no,
and start
no.
swearing at him?
No,
please
no,
don't do
no,
that, because
no, no.
it's unprofessional.
No, I'm not going to do that. When have I ever done that to anyone? Ever?
Is there anything that you would like us to give you additional training on, do you think?
Nothing springs to mind at the moment. One of the difficulties I have is the, as I see it, you know, I'm supposed to be sales, and as a percentage of what I get to do during the day, there's actually sales, it's very small.
I see Abinitia as one of the obstacles to me getting on with my sales.
Well, Abinitia...
You're joking. You are joking. We've invested over £10,000 in that software. So for you to turn around and say that it's restricting you from doing sales is wrong. And the fact is, it's preventing you from achieving sales by not using it is correct. And if you don't agree with that, then you shouldn't really be sat in this, you shouldn't really be working for us. You are there to work through the database until people either tell you to fuck off or they buy. Well, what the thing is that you're wasting my fucking money because it's convenient to you.
Where we're at, Michael, is your clarity of information
is crap.
You're finishing and your sorting and your self-organisation has got to be sorted out. And when you're confronted with it, you're confrontational. Fine, but unfortunately, you're not on high ground.
Right, well... From today, then, I will take Abinitio as seriously as I possibly can. Every time I go to Leeds, I'll put it dutifully into Abinitio.
Yeah, it's our way or the fucking highway. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm telling you.
As you say.
And if you want to do anything different, go and do it for another firm. But when you're here, you're going to say down the phone what we tell you to say, no other way. No deviation from it. Is that understood?
It is.
Good.
I don't think at the moment we can sort of accept you continuing as sales manager because you're not doing the basics. Do you understand what we're saying about that? And I think you've got the potential, don't get me wrong with that, but I do think that the time isn't right at the moment. And I think if we can just, we'll go back to basics, we'll build a solid foundation and we'll start building on top of that.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, at the end of the day, it could have been very, very negative. We could have said, these are the things you're doing wrong, and ended it at that. But we've given him solutions as well, haven't we?
Yeah.
And that's the most important thing.
I got an email. It said there'll be a chance to give and get feedback. Well, half of that was correct.
Mm-hmm. And I think...
Let's see how he gets on now.
Yeah.
They have to say that... We don't think you're doing it right, and this is the way we want you to do it. And if you have a problem with that, you can go somewhere else. Which is a bit confrontational. Apparently I'm the confrontational one. I think there was always going to be a reason, you know, why it wasn't the time yet, you know, whatever. It's nice and convenient for everyone that they can point to a deficiency in me, you know, for the time being, but, you know, in a couple of weeks, when I've been doing exactly what they've said, and my sales figures for a change aren't the leading sales figures, but I've done what I've been told, then they'll have to come up with a different reason, and I'm sure they will.
He came up here and what did he say, Anne, really? I can't really remember now. A bit blurred.
He was very, it wasn't aggressive. He was very passive, wasn't he? And he turned around and said, oh, you'd love...
Oh, this is the opportunity I've been looking for to get him out.
And he said...
There's been no cooperation on my part.
Oh, and John said, well, I've put a lot of time into you. Mm. And he said, well, what have you done for me? What have you done? You've done nothing. Which isn't... Well, I don't think it's true.
I mean, basically, he just wanted to lay blame and responsibility on someone else. You know, he's going to blame everyone except himself.
Yeah. He packed his bag, didn't he? You were downstairs.
He packed his bag and trumped off to the circus.
And then off he went, round the corner with his bag on his back.
Mm-hmm. Going humpity-hum. Trump, Trump, Trump. His heart's in the right place, but it's just in the wrong fucking universe.
motivation is a bit like having a bath. If you don't have one every day, your attitude's going to start to stink. Remember, time management, you never get back that minute that you've just taken away from yourself. The only person who can give it back the next time is you, by not wasting it and by putting priority in place. Prioritise your time and the results will come as sure as the sun rises. I promise you. Okay? We've got a great future here, we've got a great team. Let's fucking go down there and kick ass.
I think we've got the makings. We've got a core of the most fabulous team down there, don't you?
Definitely.
Absolutely, without any shadow of doubt.
I'd had enough, really, of being bent over this way, and so I just resigned. There are just two things that drive John. Number one is overwhelming sense of inadequacy, and number two is boundless greed. And you put that together with a legendary ego and a face like that, sort of the run to the litter, and you basically have John, really.
You know, the company is called Armstrong Industries. It's not called fucking kibbutz fucking cooperative.
It's Armstrong Industries, it's not Handel Industries.
I think Anne and John have private wars. I think they've got wars going on, all kinds of power struggles, whatever. And that's one reason that I had to go, because I think I might have been caught up in one of those. And of course, there's nothing I can do about it, so.
It's our way or the fucking highway. It's fucking hasta la vista down the fucking road, baby.
Next tonight, Ricky Hatton and the light welterweight world championship. Change the schedule.